What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to All Things Film. Today I'm doing a review for The Walking Dead Season 8, Episode 6. It was titled The King, the Widow, and Rick. And before I get started, just a general spoiler warning, because I will be talking about some stuff that happened in this episode. So here's your spoiler warning. 3, 2, 1, here we go. Alright, I want to start off by saying that this was a pretty good episode. You know, I really enjoyed it. I had a fun time watching it. It was a very packed episode, and that can be a good thing and a bad thing. So I think that's why this episode had a lot of mixed reviews. But personally, I enjoyed it because I love when the episode has a lot of people. And now that I'm thinking about it, it literally had the Kingdom, Alexandria, the Hilltop, the Junk. It had literally everybody except the Sanctuary. So it was a very packed episode. Everyone was like doing a lot of stuff. So first thing I want to talk about is Rick. And why is he going to, like, I don't understand this. Like, why is he going to the junkyard? Like, Rick, I love you, Rick. Like, you're my favorite character. I know it's very, like, cliche to say, like, the main character, but Rick is an amazing character, and he's so smart. Like, he's smarter than, like, a lot of people, because, like, a lot of people in The Walking Dead, they go on suicide missions. Like, in this episode, I'll talk about that a little bit. Like, everyone in The Walking Dead does stupid shit, and then Rick is, like, smart. He takes his time. Like, with Negan, he took his time, and he goes attacks in the right time. Like, he's a smart person. This is something that's not Rick at all. Like, why, Rick? Why are you doing this? I love you, Rick Grimes, but this is not good. And we find out it's not good because at the end of the episode, we see him trapped in a container with his underwear. Like, he's sweating in his underwear. Like, I don't even know what the hell happened in there. I don't want to know. Actually, I do want to know. But, so we do find out that he gets trapped in the container, and then the preview for next week, we see him coming out, and he's, like, kneeling somewhere. So I don't know exactly what's going to happen there. But that was a little bit of the episode. My favorite thing about this episode was definitely the Carl and Sadiq interaction. You know, I really love it when we see, like, a transition from the comics to the TV show. And, you know, when he said, like, everyone knew it was Sadiq, but when he said, "My name is Sadiq," I still jumped up and down. I was like, oh, my God, yes, let's go. Because it was so cool to see it was confirmed that it's Sadiq. And it was pretty funny. Like, he was like, "How many walkers did he kill?" And he was like, "I know it's very hard." And he's like, 237 or something like that. That was really cool. And then they got a little bit of a ruckus here with some walkers. And I was the edge of my seat on this. And I know it's Carl Grimes, like, he has plot armor and stuff, but we never know with The Walking Dead. And I don't know, words going around. I don't want to talk about rumors and shit, but you know, I was at the edge of my seat here, and I was so scared for Carl, because I thought he was going to get bit. I thought something, I'm slurring, because I'm talking so fast, but I thought something bad was going to happen to a Carl, and I was really worried. I was at the edge of my seat, but, you know, he and Sadiq made good friends. You know, Sadiq talked about how he has to honor his parents and stuff, and, you know, Carl, you know, it was pretty funny. Like, if I was honoring my dad, I wouldn't be here. So Carl's a good person. You know, he cares about people. You know, he bought him food and water. And so it looks like he's going to take him back to Alexandria. And that's going to be really cool. And the hilltop was also in this episode. As we see, we have saviors. Saviors, and they're sleeping outside. So this might be an unpopular opinion, but I kind of agree with Jesus. And the reason I agree with him is because there's so many saviors. I think there's like 500 of them. I read somewhere, like, there's definitely hundreds of saviors, like hundreds and hundreds of saviors. And the thing about the saviors, I think I've mentioned this a lot of times, that some of them don't have a choice. You either work for Negan as a human being, like, alive, or he kills you and you become a walker and you work in his gate, like, as a walker. So some saviors don't have a choice. And you know, I kind of believe Jesus. Like, you can't just go down the line and shoot every single one in the head. Like, you know, that's like, you can't do that. Like, I don't know, unless you're like a cold-hearted person, you can't do that. Like, that's gonna really be like fucked up. But anyways, so I do agree with this jail thing. That was really cool to see. And I don't know, I'm like in the middle, cause like, we can't keep him around, cause some of them are douchebags. Like, this fucking guy Jared. Like, he's a douchebag. You know, he deserves to die. But, like, some other people, like, this one guy, like, Jared, he was trying to break out of his, out of the ropes, and the guy, like, knocked the thing out of his hand, and he was, like, saying thank you to Maggie for, hitting Jared in the face. So, like, I feel like some saviors are good, and they're trying to turn into the good side, and maybe someone just lying, and just trying to take over, because Jared did say that this place will be ours. So hopefully nothing bad happens. What, like, in my predictions video, I said something bad was gonna happen. Somebody's gonna end up dying, and then Jesus is gonna be like, you know what? Yeah, fuck this savior, and just kill them all. And also, I want to talk about Gregory. This caught me by surprise. I didn't expect this. When they threw him in the jail, I don't know if this happened in the comics. Like I said, like I don't, like I read the comics, but I don't know everything about the comics. Like I'm not a comic. What do you call it? Like I don't read it religiously. Like I watch a show. Like I skim through the comics. Like. So I have an idea what's going on in the comics. So I don't know exactly if they did this in the comics, and I hope, and I know they. I'm not even gonna say that. I was about to give a spoiler, but anyways, I don't know if they did this in the comics. But so I was really surprised when I saw this, and I kind of felt bad for Gregory. You know, when he cut his head open, that was kind of, and he was crying. Like I kind of felt bad for the guy. But that's me being just like a soft-hearted person. Like Gregory's actually a douchebag for what he did to the Hilltop. You know. Trying to turn him over to Negan, so I was really fucked up. So I understand it, you know, but for some reason I felt bad for him. I don't know why, but that's just me being dumb. But what else do I want to talk about? Oh yeah, Rosita and Michonne. We finally got someone. We finally got these two girls back in The Walking Dead. We haven't seen them at all season. I mean, we saw them in episode one. But that's it, just a little bit. But I want to talk about this little. So we heard. Regina last episode say like the fat lady or something, and everyone thought that was the helicopter name. But no, we found out this episode it meant the speakers, because these two saviors were trying to get the speakers to go to the sanctuary and you know, attract all the walkers to leave with the speakers. But that didn't work out because Michonne, not Michonne, excuse me, Rosita, this fucking kill right here was absolutely badass. The guy was like, "You're not gonna do that, baby girl." And then she just fucking lit his ass on fire with the bazooka. That was really funny. And then also, Rick and not Rick, excuse me, Daryl and Tara, they came in. That was perfect timing. And they hit the other lady with the speakers. So they you know, they killed the savior. So they're not going to the sanctuary. And this is something I'm not a huge fan of. So right now, Tara and Daryl are on a suicide mission. They are trying to get themselves killed. You know, Dara, that's their ship name, Dara. Tara and Daryl, you know, they meet up with Michonne and Rosita, and Michonne and Rosita want to go to the sanctuary, and I guess they're going, I don't know, next episode we saw them kind of, we saw like Daryl say, we're going to finish this now, and I don't know, I hope someone doesn't die, man. Because if you read the comics, you know what's coming up with Negan. You know he's going to come to Alexandria. And I think that's going to be the mid-season finale. I'll probably make a video on my predictions for the last two episodes or something. But, oh man, I hate it when I was talking about the suicide missions earlier with Rick. You know, like he's a smart guy. He takes his time, you know. The only thing he was dumb about him was, the only thing dumb about Rick did was going to the junkyard. When I was talking about that, this is what I meant by the suicide mission. You know, I hope nothing bad happens. You know, last year we saw Rosita and Sasha going to suicide mission, and that ended up with Sasha dead. So, you know, suicide missions never work well. So, hopefully nothing bad happens, but, you know, it probably will happen. This is The Walking Dead, you know. So, I hope Daryl doesn't, you know, I don't think Daryl, you know, if I had to make a guess on who would die, I'm not even going to say it, but I don't know. I think I said it before in a video before, but I'm getting sidetracked here. So, anyways, so next week we're gonna see what happens with them. Next week should be a good episode too, cause that I guess everyone's in this episode as well, and the sanctuary. And what else? Oh yeah, the kingdom was in this episode. So Ezekiel, as we all know, I saw this coming. I think I said this in my predictions video that Ezekiel is probably gonna be locked in a room and he doesn't want to talk to anybody. And we finally figured out what this scene was. You know, in the trailer all the way back in San Diego Comic-Con, everyone was like, what the fuck? Why is she shooting inside the kingdom? Because she was trying to break open the door. And then Jerry was like, yo, the door's open. So that was pretty funny. But then, you know, this interaction between Carol and Ezekiel, one of my favorite parts of this episode. That was amazing dialogue. You know, Melissa McBride, you know, every time, you know, she gave me chills, you know, and she was in The Talking Dead too, and Chris Harrow, because, like, you know, she deserves an Emmy, and I couldn't agree more. Amazing performance by her, and, you know, I felt so bad for King Ezekiel. You know, he was holding her chain, or her by, I mean, Shiva's chain, and that was very sad. And you know, we see this a lot in The Walking Dead, where the king, or like, you know, the leader, like, or somebody, like, they get heartbroken or something bad happens to them, and they just want to do nothing. They don't want to do anything with the war, or not do anything. They just want to be in their rooms. So we see this a lot in The Walking Dead. You know, it's kind of like a cliche, I guess you could say. Oh, that rhyme, cliche, that I guess you could say. Anyways, okay, I'm getting sidetracked. But yeah, so we see this a lot, and hopefully Ezekiel isn't stuck, you know, like he isn't stuck in his room forever. I don't think it'll be. He'll probably be out by next episode or episode 8 at the most. I don't think it'll be like until the next year, or like you know what I meant, like episode 9 of 2018. So I don't think it'll be like that. Hopefully he gets out, and because, you know, Carol was saying, like, you know, the people out there, they need you. You're the king. And I think Ezekiel, I think I said this before too in my episode 4 breakdown. Ezekiel feels like everyone thinks it's his fault that people died, and that's not the case here. You know, people love Ezekiel. You know, he's their king, and hopefully he comes back and you know, leads the kingdom. And something else I want to talk about the kingdom was Henry. This is Benjamin's brother, and I was really excited to see him get screen time. Hopefully he doesn't die, because you know what happens when we start liking people. But he's obviously... The thing about Carol is that she attracts kids for some reason. You know, we got... I'm not going to name everybody, but we got, you know, the kids from Alexandria, Sam, and then we got Henry, and then we got, obviously, her daughter, Sophia, and then we had... Who else? I think we had one more kid. Oh, Benjamin, I guess you can call him a kid. Who else? There's one more kid. I think I'm missing somebody. Oh, yeah. The biggest people. Lizzie and Mika. You know, look at the flowers. I can't believe I missed them. But something about Carol attracts kids. And hopefully something doesn't happen to this little fella, you know. Hopefully. You know, it's going to be so cool seeing him in the war. You know, this little guy fighting in the battles. That'll be really cool. So, you know, I'm really excited to see what they do with Henry. So overall, I thought it was a really good episode. I'm really excited for next week and the following week, because, you know, we're wrapping up the first half of The Walking Dead. So, you know, episode 8 should be big. I heard it's 90 minutes. I'm probably going to make a video of my predictions on it. So I'm really excited for the future. And, you know, this episode was very packed. Some people weren't a fan of that. And I totally understand it, because people said that, I heard some people say, like, they didn't, like, do anything, and I understand that, I guess, because, you know, people just want action. But I like the dialogue and the one-on-ones, like, the, you know, the Sadiq and Carl thing and the Carol and Ezekiel, stuff like that I really enjoy. And maybe that's just me, and I don't know, I'm just, what do you call it, like a soft-hearted, no-action romance. I don't know what you want to call it, but what I'm trying to say is that, I like it when, I like The Walking Dead when there's no action, too, because I like the one-on-ones and the character development. And, you know, when I saw Sadiq, when he said his name was Sadiq, I was so excited. And this video has been going on for 13 minutes. Damn. But I'm going to try to wrap it up here. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, this breakdown, analysis, recap, whatever you want to call it. I hope you guys enjoyed this. You know, I really enjoy making videos like this, so if you enjoy it, too, feel free to subscribe for more content like this. You know, it's been really fun making these videos and talking about The Walking Dead. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure you leave a like rating, and thanks again for watching. It's been All Things Film, and until next time, peace.